Good morning, beloved. Welcome once again to our weekly prayer promise. Yes, it's a blessing to be back again after a short break. And here we are again just to see what the Lord has for us this coming week. I've titled this morning's message, You Must Hate to Love. You Must Hate to Love. Please take your Bibles and turn to the Gospel of St. John. The Gospel of St. John. We're going to read there. We'll go to chapter 15. The Gospel of St. John, chapter 15. And we'll read there from verse 13. We'll read three verses. Verse 13, 14, and 17. John chapter 15 and verse 13. Jesus is talking here. He says, Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. Wow. And Jesus says, Ye are my friends. Wow. So he's laying his life for his friends. If you are my friends, if you do whatsoever, I command you. Verse 17, these things I command you, that ye love one another. This is up to there, our scripture reading, beloved. Yes, our scripture verse this morning that we're going to look at is a statement from Jesus Christ himself. John chapter 15 and verse 13. Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. Now, beloved, let us get real. The natural man hates automatically. You don't have to program them. It comes automatically. Think of a little child when they don't get their way, the tantrums they throw, kick and scream. But think of our adults as well. When driving a car, for example, and someone is too close behind you, flashing their lights, for example, what happens? That road rage kicks in straight away. Or they cut you off in front of you. Not so. That is natural hate. During the Second World War, while the infamous bridge was being built on the River Kwai to connect Bangkok and Bangoon together, British prisoners of war were under great pressure. The Japanese at that time were not kind to their prisoners. They worked and starved them until they were literally just skin and bone. Many prisoners of war actually died as a result. One day, some prisoners came back from their afternoon work. They put their shovels into the storeroom and stood at attention as a Japanese officer addressed them. A soldier informed the officer, the Japanese officer, that after counting the shovels, one shovel was missing. And the officer immediately threatened to execute all the prisoners if nobody could account for the missing shovel. The Japanese officer loaded his rifle and took aim. Suddenly, a man took two steps forward and stood at attention. Looking up, he said, I did it, sir. The officer was so angry that he beat that man to death. The man was still lying there in a pool of blood when the Japanese storeman came running out and apologized to the officer and said, Stop! He said, There's been a miscount of all the shovels. And they all have been accounted for. See, beloved, one man died for his friends. That event had such an effect on the prisoners of war that after the war, there was no act of retaliation against those Japanese guards. I guess that soldier who died knew what love was. Let's have a look what Jesus said further in Luke chapter 14. Two verses there in chapter 14, verse 26 and 27. He says, if any man come to me and hate not his father and mother and wife and children and brethren and sisters, yea, and his own life also, he cannot be my disciple. Verse 27, and whosoever doth not bear his cross and come after me cannot be my disciple. Think of that missionary in India who gave his life with his family for Jesus and wrote that hymn, I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back. No turning back. In the time of Jesus, when you saw someone carrying a cross, it meant one thing and one thing only. That person is good as dead. We are to die to self. That is what it means. You must hate to love. Die to yourself. Because you cannot offend a dead man. Think about it. That means there's nothing the world has to offer you that interests you. It's as if the world is dead to you and you are dead to the world. Are you dead to the world this morning? And also, is the world dead to you? Just like a British soldier, he had to die to himself and love his friends so much so that his friends could live. Verse 27, whosoever doth not bear his cross and come after me cannot be my disciple, is a challenge from Jesus to his disciples to live like a dead man. A real disciple is someone who carries his cross. Remember also Jesus himself also took two steps forward for you and me too. And he said, I did it. He took that on himself. Totally innocent, just like that innocent British soldier. But look what the result was of that soldier's death. There was no retaliation, but moral victory. Just like Jesus. Because of Jesus' death and his resurrection, you and I can enjoy his love and peace with a victorious life. I want to ask you just three questions. Do you love others very eagerly? L-O-V-E. Just like that British soldier, to lay down your life for your friends. Second question, are you living our vision every day? That love? Are you good as dead to the world for Jesus Christ, who died innocently so that we can live forever? Third question, do you live a life of victory everlasting? Love? Do you hate the flesh and the lusts of the world enough and nurture a close relationship with Jesus Christ? Come, let us love him. And let our voices encourage this morning, L-O-V-E, by singing that wonderful hymn called How Great Thou Art, which is being sung by the Bible Baptist boys. Come now. and join us. God bless you.